So the first question is about your characters, because they are trying to find the truth in what happened, and they found something crazy, like fake reports and fake advertising. So I was wondering, from your point of view, what was the most shocking fact that really happened?
Yeah, that's there's a lot that we were shocked at as we worked our way through the season, Beatrice. I do we have to be careful here not to give too much away because some of those things happen in later episodes. But for me, it was the way that Purdue Pharma sort of sculpt a narrative that cast people who became addicted to this highly addictive drug as people who were probably fated to be drug users at some point in their lives anyway. It fated people who became addicted to an opioid as the bad guy. And when they were fined the first time around, I can't remember the exact number, but immediately after that, they started selling even harder and made even more money than they had made before they were called on the carpet. Peter?
Yeah, I mean, I think that I guess I'd never thought. Yeah, I'm always surprised these days when I even see like a drug being sold on television and there's people on swing sets and, you know, having the most wonderful day of their lives. And at the bottom of the screen, it says, you know, that this drug might cause seizures and all this other stuff. And that the fact that drugs are marketed so aggressively toward the consumer. And then the storyline that is in this that was very surprising to me also was the way that the drugs are marketed toward the doctors. You know, that these salespeople go around and wine them and dine them, and the way that they're incentivized to sell, that it has nothing to do with like it being appropriate or the right drug or anything like that. That it is being sold just the way that a car is being sold. So, or marketed. And
That's a great
I
point.
don't
And
know.
we need to be
Yeah.
able to trust our doctors. And they were basically, you know, the FDA enabled Purdue Pharma to fib to our doctors, who in turn
Yeah.
did not give us all of the best information that they otherwise would have had if the FDA hadn't had a breakdown.
I mean, how can anyone tell it? It's hard to understand, and I'm sure many doctors doubted this when they heard it, that someone telling them that any opiate is not very addictive. I mean, everybody knows that opiates are addictive. We all know that. They've been around forever, you know.
And about working with Danny Strong, because he has a great career. He's a screenwriter, he's an actor, so he's also a director. So I was wondering, how was the relationship working with him, that he has so many experience, and maybe it's different from someone that always stayed behind the camera or just wrote something?
It's nice working with someone who has some experience being an actor. You know, I mean, I've just worked with my wife directing, and I have to say, actors make very good directors and writers and people on the other side of the camera. They have, especially in terms of being an actor, you know, like they really understand what you're going through. And he would often change things because, of course, what he was dreaming up in some room by himself didn't always make sense when we arrived there. He also knew all of the information so well that it was complicated sometimes, and we'd have to ask a question, and he really always knew the answer. Or if he didn't, he knew who to call.
Yeah, I think Danny said that he started researching all of this in 2018. He had been preparing something, and then I think, you know, Beth's book, the rights for that were also purchased, and then they kind of combined the two projects, and he was right in there with all of his acquired knowledge on the subject. And of course, he was always present on set, always, you know, if anybody had a question at any time, he either had the information right on the tip of his brain, or he could call one of the actual attorneys who brought suit against Purdue Pharma to ask the question.